Wow! Everybody's got that thing. Something different we all bring. Don't you let them clip your wings. You got it, you got it. We're on fire and we blaze. In extraordinary ways, 365 days. We got it, we got it. You can dream it, you can be it. If you can feel it, you can believe it. Cause I am, you are, we are. Exceptional, exceptional.
Let's go!
Friday, November 11, 2022. I'm Joy, and today is game day!
And I'm Ethan. Welcome to today's Swarm. At this time, please stand for the pledge, followed by a moment of quiet reflection for those who made the ultimate sacrifice.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God.
Indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Veterans Day is an important holiday to be celebrated each year because it allows us to give thanks to the men and women who serve in the military right now to protect our country. These soldiers serve in times of peace and war, protecting the safety and security of citizens of our country and around the world. Veterans Day is a time for us to pay our respects to those who have served. For one day, we stand united in respect for our veterans.
The quote of the day is, "To the world you may just be one person, but to one person you may be the world," by Dr. Seuss.
On this day in history, November 11, 1918, at 5 a.m., the Allied powers in Germany signed an armistice document in the railway carriage of Ferdinand Foch, the commander of the Allied armies, and 6 hours later, World War I came to an end.
The SAT word of the day is admonish, which means to reprove or to express warning or disapproval. For example, Adam admonished his son for tracking mud into the house. Now here's weather, followed by Mr. B's joke of the day.
What's up, Jackets? I'm Nia, covering for Walker, and welcome to the weather. Today is Friday, and we will have a high of 66 and a low of 51. And will be cloudy and rainy. Why is the weather changing up on us like that? Anyway, have a good weekend. And now to Mr. B with his joke of the day. Hey, Kyle.
You can go whenever.
All right, Jackets. How do you follow Will Smith in the snow? You know? Do you know? You know? You follow the Fresh Prince. Get it? The Prince.
Attention, seniors! Attention! Apply to College Day 2022 is almost here. It's happening this Friday, November 11th, in the Media Center during all four blocks, as there will be college admissions representatives and school counselors available to assist any class of 2023 senior with starting and or completing college applications for FAFSA, college essay, and more.
And don't forget, No Fee November will be in full swing with many colleges and universities in Georgia waiving their admission application fee. So be sure to come prepared with your complete student prep sheet and submit your applications on that day. Now, let's send it off to Culinary Moment.
What's going on, Sprayberry students? Welcome to another day of Culinary Moment. And today I'm with
Kai
and Julia.
And so for the past episodes, we made like desserts, we made dinner, but I haven't seen any like breakfast and stuff. So we're making what?
Eggs, cheese, omelets.
Omelets? Sound pretty tasty to me. I'll let y'all meet up.
Our first step of starting our omelet is cracking your eggs in a bowl. After cracking the eggs in the bowl, we're gonna mix it. Now, after mixing it, we're gonna put some salt and pepper in there. So now we're gonna add cheese, and then after we add cheese, we're gonna butter our pan. So now we're gonna just cut like a little piece of butter off just to butter the whole pan so the egg doesn't burn. Now
want to wait for it to cook all the way through on each on this side before you flip the other side. And if you want to, you can add some cheese in the middle, so when you flip it over, it'll melt and it'll be all cheesy in the side.
All right, so before, this is optional, but before you flip it or fold it, you can put cheese on the top so there's cheese in the middle of your omelet as well.
Put it on one side, so when you flip it, it doesn't go everywhere.
So depending on what type of omelets you like, you can add bell peppers, you can add bacon, you can add steak, onions. But today we only had cheese and culinary, so we just used cheese. But whatever you like, you can put basically in your omelet. And now we're gonna get some on the drop.
Thank God for making me the food. You know what I'm saying? I'll see you guys on another day, a culinary moment on next week, you know what I'm saying?
Bye.
The Spanish Honor Society is collecting food for a food drive from now to November 30th. And if you can bring canned food or box food that is not expired, you can get community service hours for it. Now setting off to Zara with Sneaker Pete.
So today I'm at your scraps. What's a fashion shoe trend that should have never exist? Cause me personally, I got a lot for y'all that I'm gonna tell you at the end of the video. So let's get into this video, scraps. Let's go.
And I'm here with
Big Zy.
And you know, me are back at it again. And the question is,
what's a fashion shoe trend that should have never exist?
Converse. I hate Converse with everything I like, with everything in my soul.
And they get you a tote and it. Injury.
You get bunions wearing Converses, man.
What's the question?
You get bunions. Don't wear Converses. What fashion? What you should not be like a fashion?
Rick Owens.
Ricks. Yeah, Ricks too. Oh God, Ricks. Ricks. Ricks is just a more expensive Converse.
Let's give a shoe appreciation. What's your name?
Draco.
Let's give a shoe appreciation. Oh my God, they're so.
Alright, I'm here with
Nico.
And your question is, what's the worst fashion shoe trend?
Definitely Dirty Forces.
Why do you think that?
Because, bro, it just beat. It's done. Crease Forces, Dirty Forces. No.
Agreed. Even though mine's dirty, but it's. Alright, I'm here with
Real.
And your question is, what's the worst fashion shoe trend?
Yeezys. I don't get
what
it.
What did he say?
Why?
Kanye, you got something going on with you, boy. I ain't gonna lie.
So you like the shoe, but it's just that Kanye?
Yeah.
Woo, that'll do it.
What up, Jackets? You know it's your girl, Big Zy, not the little one. I'ma tell you the worst fashion shoe trends that ever exist. First, we got Rick Owens, them hard concrete shoes. Then we got Crocs. Why is y'all wearing shoes that was all the way in 2000s? Them lame shoes. And then we got bubble tennis slides. Now y'all, why is y'all walking around with tennis shoes on y'all feet? Tennis balls on y'all feet. Another one we got Jordan Mids, Jordan Lows. Why would you create a Jordan Lows if we already got Dunks? And those Panda Jordans, those Dunks, is trash. Straight trash. Throw them in the trash. Everybody in the world. I don't even know which one is fake and I don't know which one is real. And then we got the Converses and the Dirty Forces. If I see another one of y'all wearing Dirty Forces, it's going to be a problem. I'm not playing.
It is time to order cap and gowns for the class of 2023. Visit the QR code on the screen for packages and to place your orders. Orders can be placed with an $80 deposit and the balance can be paid off by January 31st, 2023. Your order must be placed by November 18, 2022 to lock in the current pricing. There will be a price increase after November 18th.
The Cobb Student Leadership Academy is now taking applications for students grades 6 through 12 to be a part of our 2023 season. Students from all schools are welcome to apply. The mission of CSLA is to make Cobb the best to teach, learns to lead. In pursuit of that mission, they will provide leadership training for growth, service opportunities to affect positive community change, and an environment to collaborate and empower one another. Any student interested in applying should visit the link on the screen before November 28th for more information.
Student volunteers are needed for the 2022 Sprayberry Arts and Craft Show. This year's event will be held on the November 19th and 20th. Visit linktree.com/sprayberryhigh to sign up using Sign Up Genius. Community service hours will be awarded to students who volunteer for the event. Now, sending it off to sports with Devin. Qualcomm.
Sprayberry. Hey, where y'all been at? Anyways, get ready for today, man. We too lit for the new season during this season. It's winter, so that means it's cold outside and our mom's gonna make that warm pot roast that warms up our stomachs when we eat that dinner at night. But today, the football team got their first playoff game against Gainesville at 7 p.m. today. And we got an interview with him right here! Yeah!
All right, what's up, y'all? I'm here with...
Kibari.
Mark.
Hope.
Troy.
Nando.
And they got a game tonight against Gainesville. Yes, Sirski. All right, first question for y'all. What's y'all game plan going into the game tonight?
Well, the game plan is like everybody do their assignments, then we come out with a win.
Yeah.
Same thing going on him. Everybody do their assignments, everybody lock in, everybody get 100% effort.
Yeah. Oh, God, yeah.
Well, we just need our defense to lock in, keep the offense on the field, everybody do their job.
Yes, sir.
For sure, we just need to stay together and keep pushing through it, you know what I'm saying?
Homies.
Regardless.
We throwing them haymakers.
All right, hey, so how often do y'all watch film, like, on the team y'all finna play?
We watch film every day.
Every day, me personally.
Yeah.
Every day.
Every day?
Day in, day out, on God.
Every day? All right, I heard Gainesville is undefeated at the moment. Hey, what ways do y'all stand out from the other teams that they beat? You know what I'm saying?
They haven't played nobody until they play us.
Oh, I messed with that.
You know, they play in a real.
Yeah.
They haven't seen.
Yeah, they ain't really playing no comp yet. I'm
glad. No real comp.
We gonna win.
Okay. Hey, are y'all ready to win tonight?
Yes, of course. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Also, it's hooping season. Both varsity boys and girls have a game at Dunwoody High School, including the ninth grade boys. Their game, listen, the ninth grade boys game is at 4 p.m. The girls varsity game is at 6 p.m. and the varsity boys is at 7:30. I wish success for all of us when it comes to the games. We too lit and we ready to sting, buzz, hive, drop honey and all that in the bag of chips. No, you're not coming in my second. Back up, Kyle.
The STEM Academy has partnered up with Cheers to Recycling, an organization that will come to your house and collect up to 2 boxes of glass recycling for $15. Pickup dates will be between November 29th to December 1st, and portion of all signups directly help the STEM Academy. Our goal is to make this a regular pickup, but in order to do that, we really need your help on our first round of this fundraiser. They would really appreciate your support and your commitment to recycling. For our last segment today, check out Swimming Your Mind with Nia.
What's good, Sprayberry? Today, I'm going to be taking over for Nia for Swarming in Your Mind, and let's just get right into it.
That the most fascinating problem in the world is who am I?
Okay, so I'm here with...
Belage.
Emiliana.
Big Zion, not the little one, the original.
Carmella.
And the question today is, how do you know you're not dreaming right now?
That's a good question. Okay. So usually, when I know I'm dreaming,
to wake up, I gotta blink like 3, 4, 5 times. And I blink 8 times a second. And usually when I try and run, I can't run in my dreams. So like I walk, but I done ran a couple times while I'm in school, so I know I'm woke for sure. You feel me? Or like when I go to grab stuff, it disappears. So like say you was to hand me this microphone and I grabbed it, it would just poof, it'd be gone.
That's a great answer, Elijah. Thank you.
Top two.
That is a question I'm still trying to find the answer to. Sometimes I just have to tell myself in my head, like, you're awake, you woke up this morning, like, remember, your alarm went off, like, you're awake, and, like, kind of look at my surroundings and be like, okay, no, this is real, like, just separate, like, dreams from reality as best as I can so that I don't go crazy. I get that. Thank you. Okay, that is enough.
Honestly, I don't know that I'm dreaming because every second, I think, like, what if I'm in a coma and I'm just dreaming everything right now? Like, what if I'm in the hospital because I got hit by a car when I was, like, 4 and I'm just dreaming in my coma? Like...
I'm in my coma.
They had like a whole entire, they were in a coma, had a whole life. They turned 40, woke up.
That's what I'm saying. Like, what if we all in a coma? Or like, what if we all in a womb, and then when we wake up out of the womb, we actually babies that was already dreaming.
That is all we got for you today, Sprayberry. And remember, Jack,
I told you the game.
Together we swarm.